MFD Lieutenant Michelle Whitaker, Private Robert Long, and Private Jermichael Sandridge were terminated by MFD on January 30th, 2023. Here's where their licenses stand today and how they were disciplined. According to their letters of termination, all three violated Fire Services Operation Manual, city policies and procedures, and state EMS rules and regulations. Lieutenant Whitaker's notice of termination says she stayed in the ambulance that night until a paramedic came back for equipment. Whitaker told department officials she did not know how bad Nichols' injuries were and assumed paramedics knew how to treat him. She also stated she didn't know if she could have done more to help him. Sandridge told MFD officials there was nothing he could have done that would have prevented Nichols' death. Many of the details of his role on scene that night were redacted from his termination notice. But we do know he helped treat Nichols that night. He also is seen on video not treating Nichols for several minutes. Long originally told the Tennessee Health Professional Board he was told by MPD officers on scene Nichols had been pepper sprayed and nothing else. He also told MFD officials during a hearing Nichols would not cooperate and they didn't bring an oxygen tank to the scene, even though they were supposed to. He also says he tried to get more information from MPD officers about Nichols' condition, but says all they would say is that he ran.
Nichols, you up? You okay?
Tyree.
His name?
Yeah, Tyree.
Tyree what?
Nichols.
Long and Sandridge had their Tennessee Department of Health licenses suspended. Both appealed that decision. We've reached out to TDH to find out whether or not Sandridge's appeal was as well. A fourth MFD employee was suspended for 3 days after not taking the correct cardiac rhythm for Tyre Nichols and for not bringing the correct equipment on scene that night. More on that tonight at 10 o'clock. Reporting from MFD headquarters, Bria Bolden, Action News 5.